Hey, what's on guys? I'm Arunab Chaudhary and you're watching Neolithic, and in this video we are going to take a look at Sennheiser's PX80s. Are these the best budget headphones? Okay, so let's start with the package. We get a decent package by Sennheiser. On it, it shows the headphones weigh only 16 grams and it claims to produce a natural sound. Inside the package, we find a plastic case housing the headphones in it. The case is built very solid and is a good addition with the headphones. But the procedure of putting the headphones back into the case is quite cumbersome, so I just put it in one of my bags. So now let's talk about the design of the PX80s. The design of the PX80s is quite decent. It is mostly built with plastic, having an aluminium band around it with the Sennheiser brand on it. It is quite lightweight, which should make it easy to carry for daily commuters. Now there are two leather pads which should provide you from hitting the plastic band, and the pads aren't like super comfortable or pillow like, but they do the job. The ear pads on this are disappointing. The foam pieces do get heat up and make them unbearable to use after a while. This is where I feel the company sacrificed in order to keep the costs low, which still isn't convincing to me because comfort should be a priority since it's made for outdoor use. I would recommend to go get leather cushions. The link for same will be down below. Now the PX80s have a wire of 1.4 meter in length and it lacks a mic. This feels another missed opportunity because a mic should be essential, as other budget headphones do have one. The build quality of PX80s is good, but the reliability of the headphones are doubtful. So now let's talk about the sound quality. Underneath the ear pads, we find the drivers, which are the size of my thumb. Now these drivers do not produce an exceedingly loud sound, but loud enough to be heard at 70% of volume settings. The Sennheiser says that the PX80s produce a natural sound. Now, from my experience, the drivers are towards the bassy side. The highs and mids are good, while the lows do suffer. As I said, the sound was more bass. By no means it is an ideal for bass lovers. Since the bass produced by it is deep and not thumping, so it might not be ideal for people who are looking for a headphone with good bass. For comparison, hearing Heathens by 21 Pilots was a better experience than Christina Perry's 1000 Years. Now, if you're not an audiophile, you will not notice this difference, but to me, I just had to let you guys know. So coming to the conclusion, the Sennheiser PX80s are a great pair of headphones at a budget, but it lacks in some areas, which puts it behind the competition from others and itself. Like the Sennheiser HD202 is a better alternative if you are willing to spend a bit more. So guys, that was my review of the Sennheiser PX80s. Hope it was informative, hope you liked it, and I will see you guys next week. Thank you for watching. Hey guys, so I was just editing my video and I was going through the footage and I found something really cool. So let's see that. Did you see that? Did you notice that thing? Okay, let me give you a closer look. Alright, check that out. Seriously.
Now that is awesome.